Yeah, we are expecting a good turnout and a successful tournament. We expect that all the countries will come and the level of the game will be will be such that we can see the progress that we've gone, not only in Ghana, but in Africa as a whole.
I mean, how many countries will be in Ghana, and from when to when will the tournament be held?
The tournament will be held from the 17th of January to the 23rd. That is, this coming Monday starts. We are expecting 8 countries to join us. So we have Ghana, we have Egypt, we have Nigeria, Uganda, Zimbabwe, Zambia, and South Africa.
I mean, looking at the countries that are coming, and Ghana hosting the club, African clubs in the country, that was like last year, do you think we are in a better position to host a successful tournament this year?
Actually, the ACC was a test run for the ACN. So during the ACC, it gave us the opportunity to look at certain things in the area of infrastructure, and then the technical preparation of our clubs, which consists the national team, the national team players are in those clubs. So we had a fair assessment of what to expect. And though not every country came for the ACC, those countries which came, we were able to see how we fare against them, and then the prospects that we have concerning this tournament. So I can say for sure that we are not bad at all. We can do very well in this tournament.
I mean, you mentioned preparation, and as a member of the LOC of hockey, how well prepared are you? Do you think Ghana is for this tournament?
Ghana is prepared for this tournament. There were challenges, principally about finances, which we are dealing with the help of our main sponsor, the Ghana Gas. Others have also come on board to help in their own small way. Companies like Glyco, Pinatone, Awake, they have also made some donations, and a few others. But all said and done, we are on course. We are changing some of the infrastructure. We are changing the scoreboard. We fixed new lights. The turf has been replaced, which we use for the ACCC. And other logistics that we need for the tournament, we are also putting them in place. We expected that we will get much support from various sources, but unfortunately, they didn't come as expected. But then the little that we have, we've been able to manage them prudently to get the competition running.
Looking at the strength of this Ghanaian team, where do you think they fall on the African continent at the moment?
The present ranking in the men's division, we are third after South Africa and Egypt. And in the women's ranking, we are second after South Africa. But from what we saw at the ACCC, I can say that in the men's ranking, we can move up. We can move up. In fact, our aim is to get to the finals, at least to get to the finals. And like I said, when we watch the other clubs play in the ACC, because the champions of the various countries are those who came, and we could see that we could match them and even do better. So I can say, and it's my expectation, in fact, the expectation of the board and the association as a whole, that we go up in our rankings, both in the men and the female divisions.
How will it be disappointing if Ghana don't make it that far?
Yes, it will be disappointing. Why? Well, I would say yes and no. Yes, in the sense that from what we saw at the ACCC and the preparations that we have put in, we expect, that's why I'm saying confidently, that we expect to go up. But it will not be disappointing because I don't know exactly what preparations others have put in. So you think, like we have in the local parlance, you think your house is far, but then somebody's house may be farther than yours. But then we expect to be among the top echelon. Expect it to be there.
So this year, what will make this year's edition special from what other countries have hosted?
For the first time, the TMS is being employed in Africa. And the TMS is a system whereby recording of everything on the field of play is done technologically. It's not going to be written anymore. It's going to be digital. Even the scoreboard is going to be a timer. In that, even when there's a PC, what we call a short corner, the scoreboard will hoot and give us 40 seconds for the defending team to prepare before the PC is taken. So all these things have changed, and this is the first time that is going to be used in Africa. So it's a milestone in itself. The hosting of this tournament itself is a milestone for Ghana hockey, and that's what is special about it.
What message is the president of the Ghana Hockey Association or Federation giving to the boys? Because, I mean, talking about it being a milestone, what message does he have for the African countries?
Yeah, he has met the two teams. He met the two teams the last of the 7th of January, that holiday. Yeah, he met the two teams, and he actually encouraged them and told them of the prospects. He also told them of the expectations of the board. Like I've just said, that they either win or be at the finals. Yeah, so these are the things we've motivated them in various ways. In fact, we would have loved to do more than what we have done. But like I said from the beginning, the sponsorship and then the money didn't come as we expected. So those that we had, we've tried our best to put them in a way that they will be comfortable, and they are comfortable. But we expect to do more than what we have done.
So finally, I was there for the ACC, and in terms of COVID prevention and protection, I didn't think it was at the highest level, because I saw many of the athletes not wearing the nose mask and all of that. In terms of protecting athletes and spectators, what measures have been put in place to ensure that that's well done?
Yeah, the COVID protocols was a concern for us at the ACC. And like I told you earlier on, the ACC was a test run for the ACN. This time around, we're going to have volunteers and police personnel at various vantage points. In fact, we're even going to inspect vaccination cards. But then that is something that is being reconsidered, because we know how many people will be able to enter the stadium with their vaccination cards. If they don't come in. And then we are also trying to encourage people to get involved in the game as well. So what we are going to do is that we are going to have vaccination teams at the entrances. If you have not vaccinated at all, we'll get you vaccinated. And then also, we are going to ensure that each and every single person who enters the hockey pitch will be in nose mask. The other day, we sent out nose masks to the spectators. We turn around and they took them off. But this time we are going to put police personnel and volunteers who will ensure that once you are within the hockey stadium, you are in at least a nose mask. So that's how far. And then we are also looking at spacing of the seating arrangements. Yeah, we have even made stickers to be put on so that people don't sit that close. Because Ghana Health Service has given us a 25% capacity. So we are looking at all these things. But we want to make sure that COVID protocols are strictly adhered to. The dressing rooms, the changing rooms, everywhere. After each team goes out, that place will be disinfected before the next team comes. We have a cleaning company in place who, after each match, when the team moves out of the dressing room, they get a place disinfected before the next team comes. Even the buses on which they are going to be, they're going to be. And then we have the security at the hotels. We have people who will be with them at the hotels to ensure that all these things are fully adhered to. Because you don't want to take any chance.